Okay, let's start. As you can see, these are the continuation for our lecture before. Conductor, semiconductor, and insulator can be distinguished on the ground of their conductivity and other properties. Like example, conductors. As I said before, it's like example is metal, show conductivity at room temperature, but as temperature increases, their conductivity gets reduced. Okay, yun yung nangyayari condition kapag ang conductor is nag-increase yung temperature or uminit, nababawasan yung conductivity niya. Okay? For example, sa metal, uminit siya sa room temperature na mataas temperature, edi nababawasan din yung conductivity niya. Okay, next. However, semiconductor act as the insulator at low temperature, but as the temperature increases, so their conducting properties also. Okay, sa semiconductor naman na condition is nagiging insulator siya. Kasi nga, kapag masyadong mababa yung temperatura or malamig, then ang nangyayari naman, but as the temperature, pag nag-increase naman yung temperature, ang conductivity properties niya is nag-increase also at low temperature. Okay? Semiconductor act as an insulator at low temperature, but as the temperature increases, pag tumataas yung temperature or umiinit, so their conducting properties also increases. Okay? Kasi ang semiconductor is nasa pagitan siya ng insulator at conductor. However, insulator have no such effect of temperature variation as they do not have conducting properties. Alam naman natin sa insulator, kahit tumaas yung temperature niya, or bumaba is wala tong effect kasi nga di naman siya nagko-conduct ng kuryente or it does not allow the flow of current or does not have conducting properties. Insulator and conductor can be solid, liquid, or gas, and in some exemption like glass, solid, which is an insulator becomes conductor. Okay, ito nga example, ang insulator kasi is or and conductor is pwede siya maging solid, liquid, or gas. Ang exemption lang ng glass, solid, which is insulator becomes conductor when melted at the higher temperature. On the other hand, semiconductor are present in the solid form. Okay? Next. Liquids can be conductor, nagiging conductor yung isang liquid or insulator, depends on their properties. So, absolute pure water is an insulator. Okay, yung tubig, yung pure water is insulator siya, nag-act as an insulator. The liquid metals are electrically conductive. Okay, yung mga liquid metals naman, or kahit liquid siya pero metals pa rin naman siya, ang properties niya is electrically conductive pa rin. Sa mga gases naman also become electrically conductive when ionized. Alam naman natin nag-ionize is nagkakameron ng additional or removal ng electrons. So they usually are insulator. Okay? Usually kasi yung mga gases is na nagiging electrically conductive din sila kapag na-ionize. Pero usually, ang mga gases is insulator. Okay, ito yung definition ng conductivity. Conductivity is the phenomena of transmitting something like heat, electricity, or sound. So based on the conductivity of any materials and the presence of forbidden gap, the materials can be classified as conductors, semiconductors, or insulator. In this article or example, we will differentiate the terms concerning other points on what which they are varied. Okay? Okay, ang conductivity kasi once na sinabi natin conductivity, nagtatransmit din siya ng heat, electricity, or sound. Okay? Okay, ito yung mga basis for comparison. Conductors, semiconductor, insulator. Conductors are the substance that transmit heat or electricity through them. Semiconductors are some substance or materials that may act as a conductor as well as insulator under different conditions. Are also known as semiconductor. Then, as insulator are the substance that does not allow heat or electricity to pass through them. Okay, ang conductivity niya, syempre mataas ang conductivity sa inductor, high. Semicon, moderate din. Insulator, low. Sa forbidden gap, there is no forbidden gap sa conductors. Sa semiconductor, small forbidden gap din. Ang insulator has large forbidden gap. Then, resistivity, alam naman natin resistivity or yung mga resistance, it resists the flow of current or nililimit niya yung flow ng current. Kaya sa conductor, low ang resistivity. Semiconductor, moderate din. Insulator has very high resistivity. Okay? That is the characteristic or comparison of the conductor, semiconductor, and insulator. Okay, pagdating naman sa temperature, okay, sa conductor, positive, then semicon, negative, then insulator, negative. Conductivity value, 10 raised to negative 7 mo per meter, very high. Then pagdating dito sa semicon, that is 10 negative 7 mo, 2 per meter, 2, 10 raised to negative 13 mo, per meter. Okay, pag sinabi natin mo, that is yung sa unit niya, is kabaliktaran ng resistor. Kasi resistor is ohm. Then, kabaliktaran naman, inversely proportional kasi ang conductor. Pag conductor mo siya. Okay? Then, sa insulator is 10 raised to negative 13 mo per meter. Negligible. Then, sa conductor, that is no, sa conduction niya is numerous electrons per conduction. Then pagdating sa semicon is very less number of electrons per conduction. Then pagdating naman sa insulator, that is neutral number of electrons per conduction. Okay? How about the resistivity value? Less than siya sa 10 raised to 10 negative 5 ohms meter pagdating sa conductor. Then sa semicon, semiconductor, that is 10 negative 5 ohms meter to 10 raised to 5 ohms meter. More pagdating naman sa insulator, that is more than 10 raised to 5 ohms meter. Okay, that is mga constant na value na yan. How about the current flow pagdating sa conductor? Caused by the presence of free electrons. Okay, once na nagkamera ng cause ng presence ng free electrons, magkakamera na ng current flow sa conductor. How about sa semiconductor? Paano nagkakamera ng current flow? It is caused by free electron also and holes. Pag pinag-combine yung dalawa, okay? Importante natin itong malaman kung paano nagkakamera ng current flow sa conductor, semiconductor, and insulator. How about in insulator? Paano nagkakamera ng current flow? It is caused by free electrons which negligibly present, okay? Yan yung mga condition para magkamera ng current flow sa mga materials na conductors, semiconductors, and insulator. Okay, let's continue. For the valence electrons sa conductors, there is only one valence electron in the outermost shell. Then pagdating sa semiconductor, there are four electrons in the outermost shell. Okay, alam naman natin yung valence electrons, constant na value yan. Pagdating sa conductor, one lang siya or hanggang three yung pinaka-maximum. Pagdating sa semiconductor, that is 4 yung valence electron in the outermost shell, constant na yan. Then pagdating sa insulator is 8 na yung valence electron in the outermost shell or nasa pagitan ng 5 hanggang 8 yung maximum. 8 yung maximum kasi ng valence electron siya sa insulator. Okay, how about the overlapping bands? Okay, ano ba yun? Sa overlapping of bands, the valence and the conduction bands are overlap. Nag-overlap yung valence and conduction band. Okay, pagdating sa conductor, yung napakita natin kanina, ito yung band gap niya. Nag-overlap or magkadikit or wala talagang band gap. Then how about in semiconductor? The valence band and the conduction band are separated. Energy gap niya is 1.1 electron volts. Okay, na alam naman natin kanina sa semiconductor, narrow lang kanyang band gap. Then pagdating naman sa insulator, ang band gap niya or yung overlapping ng band, both the bands get divided by an energy gap. Ang range niya is 6 electron volts up to 10 electron volts. Okay, mga constant na yan. Okay, how about sa mga bonding? Anong ginagamit natin kapag sa conductor? Okay, sa conductor, ang type ng bands na ginagamit natin is conductor are formed by metallic bonding. Kasi nga, mga metal siya. O usually, mga conductor is metal. Kaya tinatawag natin siya formed by metallic bonding. Okay, how about in semiconductor? The semiconductor is na-form siya by covalent bonding. Okay? Sa insulator naman, insulator are formed by ionic bond. Okay? How about the example sa conductor? Sa conductor, ang example natin is gold, bronze, silver, mercury, copper, and brass. How about in semicon? We have the silicon or germanium and aluminum. Silicon kasi ang pinaka mostly used. Eh. Then pagdating sa insulator, we have the mica, rubber, wood, paper, and etc. Okay? By the definition, okay, naulit lang kanina, dinefine na natin din yan. The materials are of substance that allowed electricity. Pag sinabi natin conductor, the materials are the substances that allow the electricity to flow throughout them and known as conductor. Then the process occurred because of conductors enable the electrons to flow from one atom to other by application of voltage. Okay, kaya nagkakameron ng conductor kasi conductivity, nagkakameron ng process na occur because yung conductors enable the electrons to flow from one atom to other by an application of voltage. Kailangan pa rin ng voltage or yung force niya para mangyari tong process na to ng conductor. Okay, then the phenomena of transferring the heat or electricity in any substance is known as conductivity. Okay? Okay, how about this one, electrical conductor? Electrical conductors can be metals, non-metal, or conductive polymer and graphite, then metal alloy and electrolyte. Then we have also gold, aluminum, steel, copper, and brass are the typical example which we encounter in our daily life. And the most common in the figure are elemental silver, as said above. Conductor are mostly solid metals that are molded into wires. Okay, usually kaya makikita natin sa mga wire, mga electric wire, conductor yung ginagamit natin or mostly solid metals. Okay? That are molded into wires or incised onto the circuit boards. Okay, yan yung mga application ng conductors sa mga wiring. Okay, next, mercury is the best example in case of a liquid as a conductor. Okay, mga example naman ng conductor as a form of liquid is yung pinaka-best is yung mercury. Then sa gases are poor conductor, but when pag naman na-ionize, they become good conductor. Okay, once na-ionize yung gases, since they are poor conductor, mangyayari is magiging good conductor din siya. So we can say that earth, animals, and human body and metals are conductor. Okay, naniniwala rin naman tayo na ang mga, for example, the earth, the ground, or basta may metal, animal, human body, and metals are good conductor. Kaya yun sa mga tao, usually nakakuryente sila kasi nga conductors din sila. Pwede silang daluyan ng kuryente. It means that allow transition of heat and electricity from one point to other. Okay? Okay, these are the application of conductors. Okay, first we have the iron is used in the manufacturing of the vehicle engine to conduct heat. Then we have the iron plate is made of steel to absorb more heat. Then aluminum is used in cooking utensil that absorb and store heat, and even they are used in packaging the food. Then mercury is used in measuring the temperature of the body and used in thermometer. Okay, yun yung mga application ng conductor. We have iron in manufacturing of vehicle engine to conduct heat. Then iron plate made of steel to absorb more heat. Okay. Okay, definition naman ng semiconductor. Materials that have the character to behave like conductor as well as insulator under different condition as also known as semiconductor. Okay, we can also say that materials whose conductivity lies between conductor and insulator are non-conductors. Okay, that is the definition of semiconductor. Okay, yung mga example ng mga semiconductors natin or mga circuits and electronic components. Semiconductor are used in the making of the various electronic devices like yung mga transistor, IC, and diode. Okay? These devices are reliable and low cost, easy to use, and power and efficient. Then, pinaka-example nga is yung germanium, silicon, and tellurium, and tin, or other metal oxide are few example of semiconductors. Okay, the application of a semiconductors are used in a power devices, light emitter, including solid-state laser, okay, and yung mga application ng mga semicon. Usually, kapag na-assign tayo dun yung EC or CPE, sa mga semicon company, is ito yung mga power devices, katulad ng mga solid-state laser, LED, light emitter, optical sensor, as they have voltage and current handling capabilities. And they are considered as a future elements in manufacturing electronic devices. Like yung mga sa industrial control equipment ginagamit natin, usually mga semiconductors. Then we also use it in a communication with data processing. Okay, that is the application of semiconductors. How about in insulator? We discuss. Insulator are the substance whose character are different from the conductor, as they do not allow heat or electricity to pass through them. The reason for not allowing the heat or electricity to flow is the substance resistivity, and they don't have any free electron also. Okay, ang characteristic kasi ng insulator, since hindi niya ina-allowed yung heat or electricity to flow in the substance, resistivity, kasi may resistivity siya or nag-resist ng current or does not allow the flow of current. And also, they don't have any free electrons. Since wala silang free electrons, hindi magkakameron ng current or conductors that will allow the flow of current through these materials. Okay, ano ba yung mga example na to? We have the insulator, our most solid. We have the glass, mica, rubber, quartz, wood, wool, plastic are some of the typical example of an insulator. Then one of the significant advantages of insulator is they act as a protector. As I said before, for safety purposes siya or protector against heat and electricity and form of sound too. Okay? Okay, how about the application of insulator? Okay, ito yung application ng insulator. We have the rubber is commonly used as a fire-resistant clothes, tires, sleeper as they are good insulator. Then we have in electrical insulator are used in the high voltage system. Then electric circuit board as they as used as insulating materials. Meron din siya sa electric circuit board. Then hinder the flow of electrons as well as current through them. Okay. It also used in the application of insulating materials are also covered over the electric cable and wire. Okay, ginagamit din natin siya sa mga electric cable and wire. Okay. Usually yung mga rubber, makikita naman natin ang cover ng mga cable is rubber kasi nga as an insulating material siya or nagiging cover siya ng mga electric cable. Kahit mga instrumentation cable, rubber din yung ginagamit doon. Tsaka sa mga wiring, makikita natin meron siyang rubber. It is used as a cover over the electric cable and wire as an insulating material. Then, also in woolen clothes and blankets that are used in winter to keep the body warm. Okay, that's the example of also insulator para maiwasan yung heat or malamigan siya. Okay? Okay, now we go for the difference of the three, this semiconductor, insulator, and conductors. Conductor as a substance of materials that transmit heat or electricity through them, such element or material that may act as a conductor as well as insulator, under different conditions is also known as semiconductor. Whereas insulator are the substance or materials that does not transmit heat or electricity through them. Okay, naulit lang. Conductor have high conductivity while semiconductor have moderate and insulator have low negligible conductivity. Okay? Okay, ano naman yung forbidden gap? Okay, pag sinabi natin forbidden gap, it is the gap between the valence band and the conduction band. It is not found in conductor. While there are small forbidden gap or in semiconductor and the large forbidden gap is seen in the insulator. Okay, forbidden gap is sa mga ibang libro is tinatawag din siya band gap or yung pagkaka-difference ng valence band or conduction band. Okay? How about in resistivity? Related din kasi yung forbidden gap sa band gap. Then resistivity is the property of the resistance to measure the electrical conduction, which is low or negligible in conductors and very high in insulator, while moderate in semiconductor. Okay, alam naman natin resistivity, ito yung property ng resistance to measure the electrical conduction. Or ito rin yung nag-resist ng flow ng current. Okay, sa conductor, ang resistivity is low, syempre, kasi nga nag-conduct siya ng kuryente. Then sa insulator, mataas ang resistivity. High, very high in insulator. Pagdating sa semicon, moderate lang siya ang resistivity. Okay, how about the conductivity value? Okay, sa conductivity value is higher in conductivity value than the lower in substance resistivity is 10 raised to negative 7 mo per meter. Very high sa conductor. Then sa semicon naman siya is nasa pagitan ng 10 raised to negative 7 mo per meter to 10 raised to negative 13 mo per meter. And sa insulator also have 10 raised to negative 13 mo per meter is negligible. Okay, yan yung conductivity value. Kaya naging mo siya is inversely proportional ang conductivity at resistance. Okay, it means resistance equals to 1 over C conductivity. Then resistivity value of conductor is less than 10 raised to negative 5 ohms per meter. 10 raised to negative 5 ohms meter, while the semiconductor hold the value of 10 raised to negative 5 ohms meter, kasi resistivity ohms na yan, to 10 raised to 5 ohms meter. And ang insulator naman niya is nasa having more than 10 raised to 5 ohm per ohm meter. Okay, nakita lang din ito kanina sa table. I-explain lang din. Okay, there's only one valence electron in the outermost shell in the conductor. Naulit lang yan. Conductor is one valence electron throughout. Then pagdating naman sa semiconductor, four valence electrons. Then pagdating naman sa insulator, it has eight valence electrons in the outermost shell. Okay? Then ito lang yung mga example ng conductor. It's formed by metallic bonding. Semiconductor, inulit lang on a review, is formed by covalent bonding, then insulators by ionic bond. Okay, ito yung mga example. Gold, bronze, silver, mercury, copper, brass, and etc. Are example of conductors. Then silicon, aluminum, tin, germanium are semiconductors. Okay? Then pagdating naman sa insulator, that is mica, rubber, wood, wool, paper. Okay? Okay, ito lang yung importance sa material processing. This will be the second to the last part of our lecture. All electronic devices and systems are made of materials in a various combination. Then raw materials are far from final electronic products. Then the example of semiconductor is silicon, germanium, gas, GaN. Used for devices must be extremely high purity and crystalline order. Okay, ibig sabihin yung mga semiconductor material na pumapasok sa silicon, germanium, gas, and GaN is mga devices na with have it has extremely high purity and crystalline order. Okay? Then, the desirable device quality naman niya, pagdating dito ng mga semicon, is strong functionality, reliable, long lifetime, low cost, high energy efficiency, then small volume and lightweight. Then, example nito yung mga ginagamitan ng mga semicon is yung notebook, PC, and mobile phone. Okay, they require high precision and efficient material processing technology. Okay, bago ma-process yung mga parts ng electronic components ng semicon, it require high precision and efficient material processing technologies. Okay, continuation. Raw materials, real materials and their processing, particles, line, and rigid bodies versus real materials. Then materials and specific properties determine the function and processing details of a material. Then comprehensive knowledge of a material is processing required 5 to 10 years of learning and practice. Okay, para pag sa mga knowledge ng mga materials is required 5 to 10 years learning and practice. And then we'll have the advantage and role of P6 student. Okay, ito yung mga example lang. ng mga nag-study ng mga materials. Okay, as shown in the figure, it's insulator conductor from energy band structure. Okay, these are the conduction band, NT, and the valence band. Usually, sa forbidden region, dito yan, then band gap. Okay, ibig sabihin yung forbidden region or forbidden gap, tsaka band gap is related lang din sila. Okay, kaya EG is greater than 5 electron volts pagdating dito sa insulator. Kapag sa semiconductor naman siya, that is, EG is less than 5 electrons volt. And sa conductor, partially filled band. Okay? Okay, mga constant to. Sa silicon, ang EG is 1.1 eV electron volts. Sa germanium, ang kanyang EG, that will be 0.75 electron volts. Then sa gas, EG niya is 1.42 electron volts. Sa silicon, SiO2, silicon oxide, EG niya is 9 electron volts. Okay, these are the example of intrinsic semiconductor. We have the N-type and P-type materials. Okay, ganyan yung mga itsura niya. Okay, makikita natin sa N-type, that is the, we have a pentavalent or have a P-valence electron of antimony. Then, antimony impurity naman ito. Pag sa P-type, ang example is yung boron o, yung impurity niya is boron. Okay? These are the example of doping or dope semiconductor or adding the impurity. Okay, we have intrinsic semiconductor. Carriers come from valence electron excitation. Okay. Okay, discuss lang natin to. The pure form of a semiconductor is known as an intrinsic semiconductor. At kapag pure yung form ng semiconductor, ang tawag sa kanya is intrinsic semiconductor. And the semiconductor in which intentionally impurity is added for making it conductive is known extrinsic semiconductor. Kapag nagkameron ng additional or intentionally impurities, nag-add ka ng impurity for making it conductive, ang tawag na sa kanya is extrinsic semiconductor. Okay? Okay, these are the example of a carrier type, determine a hold measure. Okay? Then these are the light emission in semiconductor. Pinapakita lang yung diagram niya sa silicon, this one. And these are for our gallium arsenide. Okay, ang EG sa silicon, that is 1.1 electron volts. Then yung kanyang wavelength is 1,100 nanometers. Sa gas, ang EG niya is 1.4 electron volts. Then ang kanyang wavelength is 873 nanometer. Then sa ALAS, EG is 2.23 electron volts, then ang wavelength niya is 556 nanometer. Okay? These are the electron hole recombination. Okay, pag sinabi natin recombination, since yung valence electron is nag-jump siya dito, papunta sa conduction band, then after nun is bumalik uli siya sa valence band, doon nagkakameron ng electron hole recombination. Okay? Kapag silicon, Si is indirect band gap, ineffective, then gas is direct band gap effect. Okay, these are the example of a basic semiconductor devices. Mga lecture natin sa mga electronics one, natakal din yung iba dyan, bipolar, transistor, diode, bipolar, BJT, or JFET, junction field effect transistor, then MOSFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. Okay, then we have the these are the, for the bipolar transistor. Ganun ang itsura ng NPN niya, silicon oxide. Then this one, itsura ng diode.